My goodness, let me just begin with you, because I'm wondering first, did you help your mom do this, record 35 years of TV news?
Well, certainly I was involved at the beginning of it, and I don't think anybody really visited the home without being drawn into the vortex. This was a kind of a consuming passion. So, yeah, I was around for the beginning of it, and on periodic visits back home, of course, you'd help out and you'd see the scale of the operation.
Mike, to use your word, let's talk about the vortex. I mean, walk me inside of your mother's home. Did she have multiple televisions, multiple VCRs? Are we talking VHS tape?
My mom started out with Beta. She understood the difference between Beta and VHS. She really preferred the Beta tapes, and I think Roger can confirm, when we watched a couple of the tapes from the 70s and 80s, the Beta actually held up a little better. So she started on Beta and was forced to VHS sometime in the mid 80s. But yeah, there would be about four or five video cassette recorders. Most of them attached to screens at various places in the house. She usually sat in a room with two TVs going, usually with ideologically opposing cable channels, kind of blaring at each other, and recording all of them pretty much at the same time. Imagine kind of piles of video cassettes precariously balanced near several machines. I think you've got the gist of it.
I'm thinking maybe some of the offices around here at CNN maybe looked like with the various televisions and things of that nature. I have to come back to you and ask you why she did this. But first, Roger, to you, because Roger, you run the TV portion of the Internet Archive in San Francisco. And just tell me, how rare is this collection from Marion Stokes? Because and also in terms of worth, did I read its estimated worth is in the millions?
Well, it's hard to estimate, but it's an exceptional collection, really an unprecedented collection. And I'm actually standing in front of one of the four containers with Sean Fagan here at the Internet Archive. And before me stands row upon row upon row of books, I mean of cartons, inside of which are hundreds of VCRs and VHS tapes. And I just randomly pulled some and see in front of me, random now, the November 22nd, 1993 CNN throughout the day. In May 12th, 1993, Fox News, NBC News, McNeil, Lair. It's remarkable.
Mike, why? This is the really the question. Why did your mom, was she fascinated by history? Did she have a love of television, a tad eccentric? All of the above? Tell me.
Certainly all of the above. I mean, my mother had been a political activist in the late 50s, early 60s. She understood the power of media to shape public opinion. And when cable news became a significant shaper of public opinion, starting with CNN in 1980, she knew this would have an effect, and she wanted to record it all. She really also had a kind of deep abiding faith in people, that if people had access to a wide range of information, they'd make good decisions. And she wanted to make sure that as much information from as many sources as possible was kept. And the Internet Archive's vision is very, very synchronous with my mom's vision. We're very delighted to be